kind of am hoping that we just trade sideways for a while. Yesterday was a very difficult day. There's some stocks that came down that I think are real buys. I'm not kidding, and I'm not talking about cruise lines. I'm not talking about airlines. I'm talking about some solid companies that have come back to levels that we haven't seen in a while. I am all in on vaccine and antibody. I think masking, social distancing, federal money till we get to vaccine and antibody, and then I think that we're okay. Then I guess we have to worry about the election, but I'm feeling a little more bullish when I look at that Johns Hopkins, that great state-by-state breakdown. It just reads better than the newspapers are telling you about how things are doing in this country.
So, I mean, that's the message today from the Wall Street Journal editorial board. So, Jim, do you think yesterday was just a scare? Shake out some of the weak hands, get a little bit of the froth out of the market,
oh,
and now we
yeah.
can still stay focused?
It's necessary. I mean, we've all seen this game that's being played where we have these stocks that go up early in the morning on our crawl. I know Stephanie and I like to get up usually right between 3:30 and 4. When you start watching what's going on, when you see underneath all of us these pictures and it's they're taking American Airlines and someone's buying United, and you want to say, are you like, come on, guys, just calm down. They're not even the greatest stocks. Take a look at some of these terrific companies with good dividends that where the stocks have just been clobbered in one day, and pick among those, and I think you'll be pretty happy.
Steph, you're not keeping these Cramer hours, are you?
Yeah, we fight for airtime between our emails at 3:30, 4 o'clock in the morning.
How about Jim's view, right? Put the last 24 hours in the markets into context about how you overall view things. You've been pretty positive, I must say.
Yeah, yeah, and I'm still constructive for sure, but let's put it into perspective here. From March lows to Monday's highs, the S&P is up 44%, and some sectors are up even more so. Energy's up like 100% in that same span. So it doesn't take much for some backing and filling. And I'm like Jim, actually, I would love just to see some backing and filling and just like some calmness in the marketplace. And then we can kind of digest the fundamentals. I think some people were expecting Powell on Wednesday to talk more about yield curve control. I don't even know if you need that at this point. The point of it is he was very clear on Wednesday that rates are going to stay lower for longer. QE is going to stay higher for longer until they hit their mandate. And the point is liquidity is here to stay, and that is very positive for risk assets. We do have to watch COVID and the accelerating cases, but you also, to Jim's point, you have to watch vaccines and the progress that we're seeing on the vaccines. I mean, J&J's news yesterday about accelerating human trials to July from September is really big news. And you had Moderna say some good things and Regeneron saying some good things. So what am I watching? I'm watching the yield spread. They're under control. They're well below March highs, so that's a good thing. S&P 500 earnings actually went up last week, so that's interesting. And then I'm looking at the economy and looking at leading indicators, and initial claims are down 10 straight weeks in a row. So backing and filling is okay, but I think we're set to see better growth in the second half of this year and into 2021.
So then, Josh, do I want to go back to the epicenter stocks that Tom Lee coined, or these reopened names? I mean, they are bouncing back today. Maybe not as much as the magnitude by which they sold off yesterday. Boeing was down 16% yesterday. It's up 7% today. I mean, that's a sizable bounce back. American's up double digits, as is United. Carnival and Norwegian Cruise Line. I think that's the one that Jim talked about earlier this morning. Some of the banks are bouncing back. So what do you buy then now?
So I think anytime you see a stock go from 50 to 70 and then back to 60 inside of 3 or 4 days, that tells you that what we're seeing has nothing to do with fundamentals or people changing their mind about the fundamentals. It's pure sentiment and then a lot of software layered on top of that. So if you're invested in a company and you see its stock price doing that, you don't really have to react. Like, there's absolutely no reason, unless maybe you're doing a little bit of trading, and then it's a different story. So I think it's like a different answer for investors and traders. The main thing I want to get across right now, though, Judge, is just because the circus is in town doesn't mean you have to run away from home and join the circus. As a retail investor, you have very few advantages, right? The pros have advantages you cannot imagine in information, in speed, in technology, in connections, people they talk to. But the one major advantage you have, if you're watching this from home, is that you're not forced to play along. And you're not forced to try to outperform over any specific time frame. Like, no one's looking at your quarterly return except for you. So take advantage of that, and don't think that you have to have an answer to every move the market makes.